And right now, let's find out what it's like being freelance for graphic designer Innocent K. Boateng.
I think it's a great way to send a message out to other Africans and other Ghanaians. People actually had that notion that you can't really make it working online from home. Fiverr is known for the competition, and whenever there is a lot of competition, like a lot of people fighting for the same thing, it reduces the value. So that is the mindset. But then, personally, people coming from my YouTube channel have demonstrated the value that I can provide for them in the videos and tutorials that I make. So they know the value that I'm ready to provide, and then they are ready to pay for that. The only limits that exist are the ones that are in your mind. Regardless of where you are from now, thanks to the internet, you can work with every single body. It's not about where you're coming from. It is about who you are and where you want to get to.
Hey everybody, it's Innocent here, and today I'm back with another video. So very recently I got featured on one of UK's biggest freelance podcasts, namely Being Freelance. And in this video, I'm going to break it down how it all started, and I'm going to attach a portion of the podcast if you want to listen, and a link to listen to the full podcast will be in the description as well. Before we dive into the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and if you're ready, let's jump right into the video. So okay, let me start off by saying that community whatsoever is very important. So I discovered this podcast about a year ago, Being Freelance podcast, about a year ago when I was searching for freelance podcast. And when I came across this podcast, the episodes were very interesting, you know, starting from web designers to writers to graphic designers. There were a lot of episodes that you can actually listen to for free. So I listened to a couple of them, and then I started following the creator, that is Steve Folland, on all the social media handles, and I joined the Being Freelance Facebook group. So when I joined, there was an ongoing discussion, and I actually made a contribution, of which the host came to reply. So I asked a very simple question that I've been listening to the podcast. As at that time, I'd already listened to about half of the podcast. So I asked a very simple question that I've been listening to the podcast for quite a while now, but I've not really seen any sort of like African or somebody coming from Africa on the podcast. And then the host actually replied that he had somebody on it. I think the person was from South Africa, and that I should go and search for that particular episode. And I actually didn't find it. So what I did was I came back to reply that I couldn't find the episode. So that was when the conversation started, that he asked me whether I'm from Africa or like, and I said, oh, yeah, I'm from Ghana. And what he said was very interesting. So he said that if I'm from Africa and I'm asking of freelancers from Africa, that means that we could actually change the narrative. Okay, so it basically means that we could change the narrative, that even if somebody has not been on the podcast, we could actually change that. So he asked me to shoot him an email, of which I did, and the rest was history. So we set a date, and then everything was set. We couldn't actually record a video section, so I'm going to play a portion of the voice, the podcast, and I'm going to leave a link in the description in case you want to listen to the full episode. So without further ado, listen to a very short portion of the podcast with Steve Folland on Being Freelance podcast.
Oh man, really looking forward to hearing your story. And how about we get started with that, hearing how you got started being freelance?
All right. So after I finished high school here in Ghana, I took up a job. That was before I got to university. So I took up a job at the printing press. And I was serving as the typee, so anything regarding typing, I would do it. And I had the opportunity to learn Photoshop from a then graphic designer. So when he's doing something, I would just go and sit by him and then learn Photoshop. I picked up the interest in working in Photoshop around 2015, and then I started watching a lot of tutorials on YouTube. So I downloaded gigs and gigs of tutorials from YouTube, and then I started practicing. Now, I had a bit of following on Facebook and Instagram, so any kind of work that I would do, I would just share it on the platform, and then people would be like, wow, this is great, you are doing well, can you do some of them for us? So I started working for free, and apparently people started paying me for what I do. So fast forward to 2017, I got introduced to Fiverr, and then I decided to make this like a real-time business. So I decided to rebrand my Instagram, post my works there, and people started reaching out for gigs or giving me gigs. Yeah. So that was how I started being freelance.
What was your experience of Fiverr like? How did you get on with that at first, and did it change over time?
I really thought it was going to be a very crazy place. The competition is very tough on Fiverr, so I didn't really pay attention to it until 2017. So it was this kind of work that I did for a friend in the US, and somebody needed someone to manipulate a picture for, and it was a friend, so he recommended me to the person. Now, when I got in touch with a person on Facebook, she said that the best place she could hire me was on Fiverr. So I thought, okay, that was a great opportunity. I quickly set up my account, and then she placed the order on Fiverr, and that was my first gig. And subsequently, she gave me 4 other gigs and ratings, and that was how I got started with Fiverr.
What would you say was like a good thing to do in terms of, you know, getting work on Fiverr? Obviously, that first one was a personal recommendation, but what things did you try out that were successful?
Okay, so in 2017, I also started a YouTube channel where I decided to share my little experiences that I've learned after I've been using Photoshop for like 2-3 years. So I decided to share that small things that I've learned in Photoshop with others on YouTube. So when I saw that Fiverr was an opportunity, like a great place to make money, I then decided to build my following on Instagram and then build my following on YouTube as well. So I started posting free tutorials for people on YouTube. I picked topics that people would be interested in. So people were coming from my social media handles to my Fiverr account. So I didn't really have to use that buyer request where people would have to use, especially when you start on Fiverr. You message a lot of people, send a lot of requests before you get your first few gigs. I just had to pull people from my YouTube account or my YouTube channel and my Instagram, Facebook, just to Fiverr.
I see. So like for those who don't use Fiverr, it sounds to me like the way you're using it that is different perhaps to Upwork, for example, is that you can create, I guess, like offers, like I will do this for you for this amount of money, and you can have any number of those on your profile. So people might click through to you from your YouTube channel, for example, and see those and then be able to buy it straight away. Was it like that?
Yes, exactly. So just like I said, I pick a particular topic. So one of the videos that drives people to my Fiverr account is how to make a church poster or a church flyer. So I do that particular tutorial step by step. And after that, in YouTube, in the comment section, I'll pin my gig that relates to church flyers to that particular video. So in case the video blows up and then have many views, the people are likely to see the first comment in a section, and I'll leave it in the description as well. So people watch the tutorial, and you see, if they can't really have time to make it themselves, they would rather want somebody to do it for them. So seeing that you can teach it actually testify that you can do it as well. So they will follow to my Fiverr account and be like, hey, I'm coming from your YouTube channel, so I saw this, that you can do it for me, and then we just get started over there.
I love that, because really, that's That's no different to when people create content and then try to get them towards their own website and then try to get them to pay for their services. But instead of driving them to your website, you're driving them to
my Fiverr account,
a platform that makes it easy to pay you, especially, I guess, because you're in Ghana. Does that make it easier to be paid? Because obviously overseas transactions can be tricky if you were dealing with them all yourself. So you have one central place in Fiverr.
Yes, that's the idea. So people, you see, when people are ordering from Fiverr, it's kind of trusty. The trust thing is there. Instead of you be like, hey, I can work this out for you, for them to send you the money. On Fiverr, they just make the payment when you deliver everything, and then they accept it, you get paid and everyone is on the same page.
That's so good. Yeah, so it's the trust as well. So you're creating videos every week, but you were doing that originally while studying. Are you still studying now, or have you finished?
Yes, I'm still studying. I'm currently level 300 in the university. I'll be completing next year.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
So the whole time, basically, that you've been at university, you've been doing this on the side. What are you studying, by the way?
I'm reading information technology in education.
So have you had any problems with working on Fiverr?
Honestly, it's the payment system that is not really great. Just like you said earlier, living in Ghana and getting the payments. For the record, PayPal is not supported here in Ghana. So if you want to use PayPal, you would have to use a different African country, or perhaps if you have a friend outside, you let them help you. So the payment would have to reach somebody else before it comes to me. Of course, I created a PayPal and then it got blocked since we are not supported. PayPal is not supported here in Ghana. So the only problem I have with Fiverr is the payment system, and also their emails delays a lot. Somebody can send you a message 4 hours later before you get a notification. And that is sometimes really, really annoying, because by the time you reply the message, the person has already gone to another person to get serviced.
Oh man, yeah, that would be annoying. So how do you cope with that when you're also studying as well as this? How do you fit work around life?
It's a very tough thing, especially when I got to my third year and I had to pick up a lot of leadership role in school and in church as well. So it was kind of very stressful. But then I think it all comes up to time management. When you're able to manage your time well, I use a lot of time management app on my phone because I'm always almost on my phone. So the alarms, the reminders, the timetable, I've got everything in place. When it's time for classes, I'll be there. When it's time to read, I'll be there. And when it's time for work, I'll also be there. So I think it all comes to time management and how you manage your time as a freelancer and then a student.
Do you know other freelancers, or is it mainly just you doing this where you are?
Yeah, there are a lot of people. So for instance, currently people are on Instagram and then they are showcasing their work. So I think they are really built. And then a couple of my friends, we are trying to send that message out there. So I've recently started a series on my YouTube channel where I talk with creatives and freelancers here in Ghana, specifically in Ghana. So I reach out to the creatives who are also freelancers, and then I let them share their stories and then their processes with others. I think it's a great way to send a message out there to other Africans and other Ghanaians, fellow Ghanaians, the youth in particular, that they can actually start this whole thing. And people actually had that notion that you can't really make it working online from home.
But the great thing is as well, is you're connecting with people as you know, as well as driving people to Fiverr, you're connecting with a community and people who refer you, I guess.
Exactly. So community is also very important when it comes to things like this. So because people, freelancing is more of recommendation. You show your works and somebody will just recommend you to somebody. They will see a post somewhere looking for a flyer designer, and then they'll be like, hey, Innocent, I saw this post here. I think you can reach out or recommend you to that person, and then the person reach out. So community is a very important issue when it comes to this whole freelance thing. Because
so you don't feel that you need to compete by going lower with your price, because actually you're confident enough that enough people are coming to you knowing that they want to work with you, not somebody else.
Exactly. So they know the person that they are going in for and what value he can provide from the videos and tutorials that I make. Actually, you can't depend on that. It's an honest thing. Sometimes it takes like 2 weeks, 3 weeks, or probably a month, and then you've not gotten any gig on Fiverr, but then the other places would be working for you. So you put all of this together, you don't actually put all your eggs in one basket. I hope you get a point.
What would you say, though, is the biggest challenge to you being freelance?
Well, my biggest challenge currently would have to be the payment system. So Instagram, for instance, people will come to you and then they would want your service. They would want you to do something for them. But then most of their preferred payment options aren't available here in Ghana. And so, like I mentioned earlier, my PayPal got blocked. So I had to depend on a friend, a Ghanaian friend in the United States. So all payments were sent to him, and then later on he would send it to me. Because people wouldn't really want to send you a direct money before you do the work for them. And you know, that is the concept of freelancing. You pay before you get serviced. So they would send it to that account. So my biggest problem right now is the payment option. I really hope and wish that the current or PayPal is currently supported in Ghana. I think it would have, and things like Cash App, I really hope it's supported here in Ghana. It would have been like a greater blessing, because I've lost a lot of clients as regard to this kind of payment option.
Now, if you could tell your younger self one thing about being freelance, what would that be?
It's all about limitation. The only limits that exist are the ones that are in your mind. Regardless of where you are from now, thanks to the internet, you can work with every single body. So put out your craft out there, start something, teach people, get recommendation, and start working on the internet and be a freelancer.
All right, so that was it. A very short piece of the whole podcast. The podcast was about 37 minutes, and you just listened to some of the very vital points. So like I said, a link will be in the description in case you want to listen to the full episode of the podcast. But then here's what I want to say. Community is very important. This whole thing came about because we were in a community. And then nonetheless, when you are in a community, you just don't have to stay idle in the community. For example, if you are in a Facebook group, a graphic design Facebook group, a writing group, or let's say a videography YouTube group, you don't just stay idle. You make sure that you make contributions. You make sure that you take part in a conversation that is going on in any of these groups. Because you know what? That was what brought about this whole opportunity. And you know, this is not just the first one. I actually got featured on one other conversation on Zoom where I had to share a couple of tips and tricks on YouTube with other creators. And that one also started from a group. We were in the same group. I made a comment and then it brought it all about. So I'm actually trying to prove a point here that if you are in a particular group, you don't just stay idle in the group. You have to actually be part of the group and make contributions, because it may actually open up like such an opportunity for you as well. And that wraps it up for this video. I hope this is not going to be the last time, and I hope I'm going to be on other podcasts as well. If you're a podcaster here, in the comment section, and then if you want to shoot me an email so that we can Fix, a podcast. I'm all up in now. And please don't forget to check the description for the full episode of the podcast. If you want to be a freelancer, if you want to take your freelance game to the next level, if you want to go a full-time freelance, Be Freelance is one of the few podcasts that you may want to be listening to. I've been listening to it for about a year now, and it has changed so many things, perspectives from selling to pricing to marketing to promoting yourself, setting up brands. It has been really helpful. If you want to go into freelance full-time, make sure you subscribe to that podcast and listen to the episodes. Thank you once again for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. It's Innocent here, and Steve over there, he wants to cut it out. I'll see you guys in the next one. It's Innocent here, and bye. Cut.